Is it really me? Is it really true? Suddenly I'm beautiful, being here with you. Deep inside your eyes, someone's face I see. Someone who is beautiful. Is it really me? Moments ago, I was alone, hoping that this could be. Now here I am, safe in your arms, and I'm no longer lonely. Is it really me? Can't believe it's true. Suddenly I'm beautiful, all because of you. Suddenly I'm beautiful, beautiful with you. Moments ago, I was alone, hoping that this could be. Now here I am, safe in your arms, and I'm no longer lonely. Is it really me? Can't believe it's true. Suddenly I'm beautiful, all because of you. Suddenly I'm beautiful, beautiful with you.
Thank you. Barbara Harris originated the role of Daisy Gamble, also known as Melinda, in On a Clear Day, You Can See Forever. It's quite a convoluted story in which Daisy goes to a psychiatrist to try to quit smoking and under hypnosis reveals she's been reincarnated. Now, she also has ESP and can make plants grow. So right now, I need all of you to help me, please, and pretend that you are plants. Not that hard. Hey, buds below, up is where to grow, up with which below can't compare with. Hurry, it's lovely up here. Life down a hole takes an awful toll. What with not a soul there to share with? Hurry, it's lovely up here. Wake up, bestir yourself. It's time that you disinter yourself. You've got a spot to fill, a pot to fill. And what a gift package of shower, sun, and love. You'll be met above everywhere with fondled and sniffed by millions who drift by. Life here is rosy if you're a posy. Hurry, it's lovely here. Come rhododend, courage, little friend. Everything will end, rhododendy. Hurry, it's lovely up here. Bloom, buttercup, buds are better up. Where in case of nuptials you're handy. Hurry, it's lovely up here. Climb up, geranium. It can't be fun, subterranean. On the exterior, it's cheerier. RSVP peonies pollinate the breeze, make the queen of bees hot as brandy. Push up azalea, don't be a failure. Come up and see the hoot we're giving. Come up and see the grounds for living. Come poke your head out. Open up and spread out. Hurry, it's lovely. Here.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. You are all lovely plants. Thank you. She Loves Me tells the stories of Amalia and Alona. In a trip to the library, Alona sings of meeting a stranger.
Let me tell you, you've never seen anything like that library. So many books, so much marble. And so quiet. And suddenly all of my confidence dribbled away with a pitiful plop. My head was beginning to swim and my forehead was covered with cold perspiration. I started to reach for a book and my hand automatically came to a stop. I don't know how long I stood frozen, a victim of panic and mortification. Oh, how I wanted to flee. When a gentle voice, a kindly voice, whispered, "Pardon me." And there was this dear, sweet, clearly respected, thickly bespectacled man who stood by my side and quietly said to me, "Ma'am, don't mean to intrude, but I was just wondering, are you in need of some help?" I said, "No. Yes, I am." The next thing I know, I'm sipping hot chocolate and telling my troubles to Paul, whose tender brown eyes kept sending compassionate looks. A trip to the library has made a new girl of me, for suddenly I can see the magic of books. I have to admit, in the back of my mind, I was praying he wouldn't get fresh. When all of the while I was wondering why an illiterate girl would attract him. Then all of a sudden he said that I couldn't go wrong with the way of all flesh. Of course it's a novel, but I didn't know, or I certainly wouldn't have smacked him. He gave me a smile that I couldn't resist. And I knew at once how much I liked this optometrist. "You
you know what this dear, sweet, slightly bespectacled gentleman said to me next? He said he could solve this problem of mine. I said, how? He said, if I'd like, he'd willingly read to me some of his favorite things. I said, when? He said, now. His novel approach seemed highly suspicious and possibly dangerous too. I told myself, wait, think, dare you go up to his flat? What happens if things go wrong? It's obvious he's quite strong. He read to me all night long. Now how about that? It's hard to believe how truly domestic and happily hopeful I feel. I picture my Paul there reading aloud as I cook. As long as he's there to read, there's quite a good chance indeed, a chance that I'll never need to open a book. Unlike someone else, someone I dimly recall, I know he'll only have eyes for me, my optometrist, Paul.
When I saw Les Mis many years ago, I was blown away with this next song. In the story, Fantine, a working mother who is single, loses her job and reflects on her broken dreams.
I dreamed a dream in time gone by, when hope was high and life worth living. I dreamed that love would never die. I prayed that God would be forgiving. Then I was young and unafraid, and dreams were made and used and wasted. There was no ransom to be paid, no song unsung, no wine untasted. But the tigers come at night with their voices soft as thunder, as they tear your hopes apart and they turn your dreams to shame. Still I dreamed he'd come to me, that we would live the years together. But there are dreams that cannot be, and there are storms we cannot weather. I had a dream my life would be so different from this hell I'm living, so different now from what it seems. Now life has killed the dream I dreamed.
Thank you. As a child, I loved watching Walt Disney animated films. My favorites were Lady and the Tramp, Pinocchio, and Cinderella. And when my son was growing up, he couldn't get enough of Mary Poppins. He played that videotape over and over again. Yes, I said videotape before on demand. And when I was a teacher,
I put together a medley of songs that were sung by women in children's literature. So I thought, what a great idea to add to this show songs that have been sung by female characters in Disney animated films.